Project manager or scrum master? Scrum master or project manager? Who the heck they are? And how do this role differ? Let's knock it down. Hey there, what is up everyone? If we have never met before, my name is Chris and you are in my project management sandbox. I'm a PNP and Lean Six Sigma certified project manager with a wide experience in the tech industry projects. And here I am sharing my tips and tricks about managing projects. So if you want to know more tips and tricks on project management, make sure to subscribe, tap the notification bell to be notified about new videos on Wednesdays, and let's get back directly to our topic for today. In this episode, we are going to break through the ambiguity between two project leading roles. So we are going to define who is a project manager, who is a scrum master, how this role differ and if they differ. And also we are going to define when do we need to call for a project manager or for a scrum master. And stay till the end because the goal of this video is to make it crystal clear on who these guys are and when do we need them on a project. Let's get started. First of all, let's start from the roots. And when I'm referring to the initial source, I'm talking about the project management or product delivery methodologies that have made us differentiate these two roles, project manager and a scrum master. And here I'm referring to the adaptive, agile project management methodology or product delivery methodology and its frameworks, and to the classical predictive one, which we call waterfall. The granddad of the software development and project management is waterfall. To make a quick recap, we pick waterfall for projects that usually have constraints in time and budget. And for such projects, we aim to plan everything much in advance. Therefore, waterfall is also called predictive. We do not welcome changes with waterfall, and we put a lot of labor in the initial research, documentation, schemas to build the overall project management plan. Thus, if a project is using waterfall, I doubt it could survive without a project manager. Later on, with the evaluation of the product delivery techniques, the world has come to the new adaptive methodology, which is agile. And Scrum is one of the most popular flavors of it. Actually, I'm not going to dive deep into this right now, but if you want to know how to differentiate the most common project delivery methodologies, make sure to check this video when I'm breaking down all the most popular project and product delivery methodologies and helping to define how to pick the most appropriate one for the project. Just in a couple of words, the general idea of agile and the general difference between agile and waterfall is flexibility and adaptability. So agile welcomes changes, it can implement changes on a fly, it retrieves feedbacks, it implements improvements after the feedback is received to deliver the better product and to deliver it faster. That is why it is called adaptive. So who leads projects with both methodologies? And by the way, let me know in comments which project management methodology do you prefer on projects. We all know who project managers are. If we can recall, project management is generic, cross-functional and multi-applicable. And in the general mindset, project managers are typically stick with the classical waterfall methodology, which assumes that the project has five delivery stages. They are initiation, planning, executing, monitoring, controlling, and closing. This is what we are taught by the Project Management Institute. This is what we are getting certifications on. And if you want to know more details about the project management duties, make sure to check this video where I'm outlining step by step what do we usually do to deliver a project. However, this is not that simple. So actually educated and experienced project managers can efficiently manipulate and exploit both classical and adaptive methodologies. And we can efficiently pick the one that is more appropriate for a project and even mix and hybrid them to make the delivery of the project the most efficient that it needs to be. Okay, but who the Scrum Master is and why that many organizations are struggling to define if they need a Scrum Master or a Project Manager. To proceed with, let's look into the definition provided by the Scrum Alliance and identify who is the Scrum Master according to their opinion. So the Scrum Master is the team role responsible for ensuring the team lives agile values and principles and follows the processes and practices that the team agreed they would use. The responsibilities of this role include clearing obstacles, establishing an environment where the team can be efficient and effective, addressing team dynamics, ensuring a good relationship between the team and product owner as well as other outside the team, protecting the team from outside interruptions and distractions. So, in other words, Scrum Master is delivering the clear expectations about the project to the team, and also he or she is delivering the requirements of the project, making sure the project has all the necessary resources, both human and material, works with the team to evolve and to improve the collaboration, manages communication and stakeholders' engagement, and works with risks and their mitigation. That is a really important role, don't you think so? But finally, how does Scrum Master differ from a project manager? Finally, don't you feel that a Scrum Master and a project manager are the same people? They both have similar accountabilities and they execute similar activities. Both of them are responsible for planning, schedule, cost, quality, risks, resources, communication, stakeholders, and so on. All they do is the same. The difference is in the title, actually. So that is why when we do waterfall, we usually call for a project manager. And when we're doing agile, we want a Scrum Master on the project. Well, obviously, if we more do waterfall and if we stick with this approach, we get more proficient in classical project management. If we narrow to agile and all we do is practicing agile and scrum methodologies, we are getting closer to a scrum master. However, more or less the rules are pretty much similar to each other. So let me know in comments which rule would you prefer in a project. So now you know exactly who a project manager is and who a scrum master is, how these guys differ, and when do we need a project manager or a scrum master on a project. If you like this episode, don't forget to hit the like button, share it with your friends, and see you next week. Bye!